The O1 model is recognized as one of the most powerful reasoning AI models today, often outperforming experts on complex PhD-level questions. Yet, many clients remain cautious about using OpenAI's models due to data privacy concerns. Now imagine the possibility of building a model comparable to O1 that runs locally on private infrastructure. A promising solution is NVIDIA's brand new model, Llama 3.1 Nemotron. With just 70 billion parameters, it's compact enough to run locally or on GPU providers like RunPod, yet powerful enough to outperform models like GPT-4 and Claude 3.5 Sonnet in benchmarks. In the next few minutes, I'll show you how to build this GPT-01 clone and run it locally or on RunPod, complete with an easy-to-use interface like OpenWebUI. We start on the Llama website, and we see that Llama provides us with various versions of open-source models. We search for Nemotron, and we see that the 70 billion parameter model is made available to us, and that's exactly what we want to use. First, we need to install Llama, depending on which operating system we have. In my case, I'm trying it locally first and downloading the Mac version. After the version is downloaded and installed with a double click, I can start Llama with the command Llama run and then the name of the language model. I say hi and the answer comes. However, you can already see that the generation of the answer is relatively slow. This is because the 70 billion parameter model is running here on my Mac Studio, which wasn't specifically designed for language models. This means for daily work, it would certainly be too slow and not a real alternative to other options. Therefore, I would like to present a way how we can install the language model not locally, assuming we don't have strong computers with a powerful GPU, but rather how we can rent an instance with a strong GPU and access it locally with programs like OpenWebUI. The first step to enhancing your Nemotron experience is to visit the RunPod website and sign up or log in. And the first thing we need to do at RunPod would be to check if we have credit, as these instances with large GPUs are not free. In my case, I don't need to top up because I still have 17.92 euros credit, and I can start directly with installing a new pod. Here we see a selection of different GPU instances. I choose the A600, which is quite expensive but also very powerful, with 48 GB VRAM. That should be more than sufficient to start the language model. It's important that we increase the disk storage, otherwise the model wouldn't fit when downloading. Additionally, we want to expose Llama to the outside, so we need to expose port 11434. Then we have everything we need and we can deploy the instance. It takes a few minutes until the instance is available, and after that we can access it in different ways. Spinning up GPU instances with RunPod is straightforward, but it's essential to keep an eye on costs. For example, running an instance for an entire day would cost me approximately $18. When we click on Connect, we have the option to connect via SSH. In my case, I want to do this via a web terminal, so we simply click on the Start Web Terminal button, and we see a shell in the browser that we can interact with. I copy the command to install Llama on Linux, and within a few minutes, Llama is installed. We see that Llama is now available on port 11434. With Llama serve, we can start Llama, and now we need a second window to test Llama. For this, we go back to the RunPod page where we manage our pods. We go back to Connect and connect to Web Terminal. We can download our chosen language model by entering Llama pull followed by the name of the model, in this case, Nemotron. I have accelerated this here significantly because downloading the 42 GB took a few minutes. Now we can start Nemotron with Llama run Nemotron, and we say hi again, and we already see that it produces the answers much faster. I'd say it's as fast as GPT-400, which should be sufficient for our needs. When it also accomplished the quality and the reasoning similar to GPT-01, we would have a perfect privacy solution. Let's pose one of the trickiest questions for language models. How many R's are in strawberry? And it answers one. We see here why we need to refine our prompts and force it to think very carefully. Because when we ask twice, it eventually comes to the right answer. But what we want, of course, is for it to do this correctly the first time. We'll get to that in a moment, but first I want to show a way how we can access our Olimar instance much more comfortably with a graphical interface. For this, however, it's necessary that we can access our instance via an API call. I'll try this out with curl. First, a curl request against localhost, where I simply specify the system role as "you are a helpful assistant" and just say "hello," and if all goes well, this request should go through and be answered. It takes a moment since we don't have streaming of the answer, and it takes until the complete answer is generated. There it is, and we can see that under the key content, we have a similar answer to what we just saw on the console. Good. Now our goal is, of course, that we can reach our Olimar instance from the outside. And for this, we need to make a small adjustment. This involves making Olimar respond to external connections. And for this, we set the environment variable Olimar host and set it to 0.0.0.0. Now we can also try locally to access it via the URL of our RunPod machine. We're using the URL of our RunPod instance. The 11.43.4 in the first part of the URL specifies the port we want to access. And here it looks good too. Great. The next step is then to try to make contact with OpenWebUI to this Olimar instance. Installing OpenWebUI is straightforward. Links to the documentation and a step-by-step video tutorial are provided in the notes. Under settings, we can adjust the Olimar URL accordingly and use the URL to our RunPod instance. We verify the connection to see if it works, and it looks good. And now we should be able to use it with OpenWebUI. We select the model, say, "Hi, how are you?" And we see the answer, and also with the same speed as we just had directly on the RunPod instance. The great thing is that you can also add your documents to OpenWebUI, ensuring everything stays 100% private. Perfect. Now it's about adjusting our prompt accordingly in the last step. For this, we go to the settings and enter an appropriate system prompt. You are a highly logical assistant. Whenever answering a question, you must provide a clear step-by-step explanation of your thought process. And now we ask again, how many R's are in strawberry? And we see that it now starts to actually break down the task into different steps. And I suspect that it will find a correct answer to this task that is very difficult for language models. And the answer is correct, and we see that we now have a very powerful language model that is exclusively available to us.